Today we're talking about long exposure street photography, and I'm going to give you 5 tips that helped me to get photos like this one, or this one, or this one. Okay, let's go. Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. I am Aris and I'm back. I'm back to the studio. It's been a while. My hair got longer. You all got much prettier. Yeah, indeed. And today we are talking about long exposure street photography. We're going to talk a bit about the settings to use to do this kind of photos, and I'm going to give you 5 tips that helped me a lot, that helped me a lot in general when I want to take photos like that. Before we jump into the video, guys, remember to hit the like button down below because it does help a lot. Subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell if you haven't done already. Comment, share all of this good stuff, and let's go. So in terms of the settings, what kind of settings do you need to have? So generally, to do this kind of long exposure street photography, to get this movement, this flow of movement in your photos, you need a shutter speed, a slow shutter speed. You need a shutter speed between 1 to 25, all the way up to 1 second. Also, because in this kind of photos, usually you want everything to be sharp or as sharp as possible, you need an aperture of f13, f8 to f13. Also, the higher the f number, the higher the aperture you have, the smaller is the opening of the lens and the less light you're going to get into your sensor. This is very important because when you slow down your shutter speed to get this kind of long exposure shots, you start getting too much light into the sensor. So the aperture, apart from helping you to choose what's going to be in focus or not, it also helps you to control how much light you're going to have into your sensor, and it will help you to control the highlights so you don't blow up the highlights. And then of course we have the ISO. For these shots right here that I got into the subway, I used an ISO of 640, and that's because the light into the subway was quite dim, so we need to bump up the ISO to balance the exposure according to the exposure meter. Now, if you want to do this kind of effect outdoors on a bright sunny day, it helps a lot if you have with you an ND filter. The ND filter works a bit like sunglasses, and it cuts some of this intensity of the light so you can slow down your shutter speed without blowing out your highlights. I don't want to talk about the settings way too much because I'm planning a video to discuss just about the settings, nothing else, but I think this will be enough. This information will be enough to get you started. Now let's go into our 5 tips. Now, tip number 1, you have to be super steady. You have to be as steady as possible because with this kind of slow shutter speed, the slightest movement of your camera, of your hands, will be depicted inside your photo. You will see a little bit of blur. One good tip that can help you be very steady is to use your elbows. You can push your elbows against your body, keep your camera here, and try to be as steady as possible. This helps a lot. Let me demonstrate with the Sony 6400. Sony 6400. You see, so you basically stay like that, very, very steady, click the shutter button, boop, that's it, you don't move, very, very steady, all right, that's it, you got the photo. So if you want to do this kind of photos with a very steady subject, a nice in focus subject, and everything else around it moving, like for example here where we have the steady, the very sharp mirror in the subway, and we have the train moving, and you can see the nice flow of movement on the train. Now, if you want to do this kind of stuff, it's good if you focus on subjects that are steady. This could be the mirror, as we have here in this photo, or it could be a person who is not really moving that much. Here, it helps a lot if you have a person, a friend, or someone else that is with you and you are taking photo of them, because you can tell them to try to be as steady as possible. If you don't have a friend with you, then you have to find some stranger around you that is not moving that much. Now, tip number 3, it is very helpful for you to have a camera that has optical image stabilization, IBIS. Sony A7 III has that, and it's very helpful when you want to do this kind of longer exposure street photos. Sony 6400, on the other hand, doesn't have that, so it's more shaky, and this translates to more motion blur. This doesn't mean that you cannot do it with the Sony 6400. Definitely you can do it with the Sony 6400, but you will have to do very, very careful and as steady as possible. At this point, let me tell you that, of course, if you're outside and you don't have a tripod and you cannot use a tripod, you can use any surface you can find around. Obviously, I'm not talking too much about that because the point of this video is how you can shoot long exposure photos handheld. But just in case, if you can use a surface around, use a surface that you can find around, okay? Let's move on to the next one. So tip number four is shoot the same scene multiple times. And why is this important? When you're doing long exposure street photography, you never know the exact result you're gonna get in the end, because obviously people are moving, trains are moving, buses are moving, etc., etc. So the end product will be a little fluid. It might be looking great as you would expect, but it might not be as good because of reasons. So for this, you should take basically the same frame multiple times, so you end up having the frame you like, with the kind of patterns of movement that are pleasing to you. Don't be afraid in general to try again the same thing to get the result you want. It's not a bad thing. It doesn't say anything bad about you. It only will help you to get better photos in the end. And let's go to the last tip, which is tip number five, which is be creative. Now, having a sharp element into your long exposure street photos is a good thing, yeah, okay. But having everything with some motion blur is not too bad either. Actually, you can add a little bit of motion to your long exposure street photos to make them look a bit painterly. They will look a bit abstract, but they will have this extra artistic element. If you want to be very creative with it, you can, and you can create some really, really nice compositions. So do not try to have everything absolutely sharp all the time. Be creative and you can get photos like this or this, for example. By the way, for this one, the second one, what I've done here is that I started taking my long exposure from a steady position and then quickly I moved. So you get a little bit of your scene in your photo, but at the same time, because of the move, you start getting light painting all over your photo as well. I do love this technique very much. I think it's very creative and you can create some really, really nice and interesting stuff like that. And these are our five tips for today, guys. I hope you liked them and they were useful to you. I want to see your long exposure photos if you manage to get some on Instagram. Again, if you want to show me these photos, use hashtag 20,001 steps a day in your photos or tag me and I will see them. If you enjoyed the video, guys, remember to hit the like button down below, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to get all of the notifications for my future videos. Comment, share all of this good stuff and thank you very much for watching. Until next time, bye bye.